Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the terms associated to the spherical mirror. In the previous class, we studied about the spherical mirror. There are the two types, concave and the convex mirror. Today we will discuss about the some of the terms which is just related to the spherical mirror, about the ray of the light. Okay, so we will discuss about the terms of the spherical mirror one by one. Now, first one is pole of mirror. First one is, what is the pole of mirror? Second one is center of curvature. Third one is radius of curvature. Fourth one is aperture. Five number is principal axis. Sixth number focus. And last one we will discuss about the focal length. So there are the seven terms which is associated with related to the spherical mirror. We will discuss one by one. Now let's talk about the pole of mirror. What is that pole of mirror? You have seen the previous class, the spherical mirror. In that spherical mirror, we have seen the curved mirror and the convex mirror. So I will draw you a diagram. This is the which mirror? Concave mirror. Yes, this is a diagram of concave mirror. Now, what is the pole of mirror? Pole of mirror means, as you know, the center of the reflecting surface. You have seen here in this spherical mirror, there must be at the central point at the where there will be the flat point in this sphere. So this reflecting flat point, there is one point, will be what? Flat. Here the flattening point of the or the middle of the spherical mirror reflecting side, that is called what? Pole of mirror. That is the what? Pole of mirror. This pole of mirror is denoted by O or P. What is O or P? We can note it with the denoted with the O also, or we can write also the P. So I am going to write the P. Means P became now the pole of mirror. What is pole of mirror? It means the geometrical center of the mirror. The geometrical center of the mirror. That is the in the concave mirror also, in the convex mirror also. That is called what? Pole of mirror. It is the center of reflecting surface. Now, this is the reflecting surface. We have seen inner side is reflecting surface. So, it is the concave mirror, convex, concave. Concave mirror. Yes, this is the reflecting side and the middle of that reflecting side, that is called what? Pole of mirror. That is pole of mirror. In convex mirror also, inner side is polished. The middle point of the reflecting side, this is the word pole of mirror, which may be denoted by P also or O also. So as you like, you can denote with O also. So I'm going to note with O. This is the word pole of mirror in concave mirror, convex mirror. So do you understand what is the pole of mirror? What is the pole of mirror? The center, the geometrical center of the mirror. The geometrical center of the mirror, that is called pole of mirror. Once again, the reflecting surface at the center of the mirror, that is called what? Pole of mirror. It is denoted by P or what? O. Now another term is center of curvature. What is that center of curvature? Now center of curvature. What is that center of curvature? Center of curvature means the central point of a spherical mirror. What is? So I will show you. This is the sphere. It is the center of a sphere. What is this? Center of a sphere. So means when we cut and form a mirror, means that is the center. This is denoted by P. Yes, this is the center. This is the what? Center of curvature. This point is the center of curvature. What is? This is the what? Center of curvature. Center. Spherical. Sphere. The center of this sphere. This is the center portion of this sphere. And so, the center of curvature is what? It is the center of the what? Like the radius, you can say. The center of the sphere, that is called center of curvature. Yes? C, it is generally denoted by C. Center of curvature is denoted by C. And this center of curvature is formed in a concave mirror and a convex mirror difference. In concave mirror, it is formed inside, yes, in inner side, but in convex mirror, it is formed outside. Like I will show you. Here, this is the inner surface is polished in convex mirror. It means it is a center, but the center of curvature is formed outside, reflecting side, this side. This is the center of curvature in where? In convex mirror. In concave mirror, it is inner side, it is reflecting side. But in convex mirror, outside, outer is the reflecting side of the center. So here is formed. That is the what? Center of curvature. This is the center of curvature. In concave mirror, inner. In convex mirror, outside. So, what is the center of curvature? The center of curvature means the center of the sphere of which a mirror forms a part. It called what? Center of curvature. Okay. So, center of curvature, it is formed in concave mirror inside. Yes, in the reflecting side, but in convex mirror outside. Outside in what? In the same as the reflecting side also, outside. So here we have seen this, the both diagram, figure number 1 and this figure number 2. This is the concave mirror and this is the convex mirror. You have seen, look carefully, where the center of curvature is formed. In concave mirror and in convex mirror. It is a difference. In concave mirror, inner side, reflecting side, inner side. In convex, the center of curvature is formed outside. Outside is also the reflecting side. Okay? So, you must understand where is the center of curvature is lies. Okay? What is the center of curvature? Center of curvature is what? The central part of what? Spherical mirror. Okay? Now, third one is radius of curvature. Now, another term is radius of curvature. What is radius of curvature? This radius of curvature is denoted by capital R. Now I will show you where is the radius of curvature. Now, as you know, this is our sphere, and now I will got to make one spherical mirror. Now this is the what? Spherical mirror. Now this is the what? As you know, center of curvature, and this is the pole of mirror. I have already told you about this one. How we understand what is the pole of mirror and what is the center of curvature? Now, radius of curvature. Radius of curvature means the actual length or the distance between the center of curvature and the pole of mirror. That is called what? Radius of curvature. Now, this is the center of curvature and this is the pole of mirror. This is called what? Radius of curvature, which is denoted by capital R. What is the distance between the center of curvature and the pole of mirror? This is called what? Radius of curvature. So, another way we can also define as the radius of the sphere of which a mirror focus a part, forms a part. This is the one part. Yes? So, this is called what? Radius of curvature. Now, in another, inner side in convex mirror, this is the what? Center, and this is the pole of mirror, which is denoted, pole of mirror is also denoted by O or P. So, center of curvature is always denoted by C. So, this is the what? Center of curvature to the pole of mirror. This is called what? Radius of curvature. So, I am showing you in both case, in center of curve that in concave mirror also, in convex mirror also. So try to understand. What is that? Radius of curvature. And this is the radius of curvature. This is the, which is denoted by, this is the figure number 1 and figure number 2. This is convex and this is concave. So once again listen, what is that radius of curvature? The actual distance between the center of sphere, center of what? Center of curvature and the pole of mirror, that is called radius of curvature. What is that? Radius of curvature, which is denoted by capital R. Now another term is aperture. Now another is aperture. Aperture means what? The reflecting surface of the mirror, that is the aperture. The reflecting surface, this is the mirror. This is aperture, is the reflecting, the surface of the mirror from which the reflection takes place, that is called the aperture. The reflecting surface of the mirror, that is called what? Aperture. It may be denoted by, we can, anyone, x and y also you can use. Yes, this is the reflecting surface. This is the reflecting surface, is known as what? Aperture. Yes, another is, now this is the principle of axis, is the main things we have to understand, must understand. What is the principle of? Now, principle of axis. What is the principle of axis? The straight line passing through the pole O and the center of curvature C of the mirror is called principle of axis. Now I will show you. This is a concave or convex. Concave. This is the concave mirror. This is the center of curvature. This is the pole of mirror. This is the radius of curvature. Yes? Now, what is the principle of axis? Principle of axis means the straight line which is passing from the center of curvature to the pole of mirror. Listen carefully. When a straight line passing through the center of curvature to the pole of mirror, this is called what? Principle of axis. This is the principle of axis. The straight line which is passing from the center of curvature to the pole of mirror, that is called principle of axis. Once again, the straight line which is passing from the center to the pole of mirror, that is called principle of axis. This is the in concave mirror. Now I will show you in the convex mirror. This is the diagram of the convex mirror. Inner surface is polished. This is the center of curvature. This is the pole of mirror. When a straight line is passing from the center of curvature to the pole of mirror, straight line, that is called principle of axis. What is that? Principle of axis. Now this line we can also note it, like as we can write any things, maybe x we can note it also. X, now x and p is what? Principle of axis. Here we can also denote it, y, any way you can denote it. And now p, y is the principle of axis. What is the principle of axis? The straight line which is passing from the center of the curvature to the pole of mirror, that is called what? Principle of axis. So now you will see in this concave and convex mirror, both figure number 1 and figure number 2. I will show you by the drawing, by the help of the diagram also. So you have to note it. Okay, what is the principle of axis? What is the principle of axis? Means what? The straight line which is passing from the center to the pole of mirror. Now here you have seen that this is the center and this is the pole of mirror. A straight line which is passing from the center of curvature to the pole of mirror. That is the principle of axis. Now another is focus and the focal length. Now focus. What is that focus? Focus means the point which is lies at the center of curvature and pole of mirror, in that between. How? Now I will show you. This is the concave mirror. This is the center of curvature. This is the pole of mirror. This is the principle of axis. Yes? Now, the point between the center of curvature and the principle of axis. On the point on the principle of axis between the center of curvature and the pole of mirror, that is called focus. Now, I will show you the distance, actual distance, equal distance on the principle of axis. This point is called focus. Here, in this focus means, if the radius of curvature is 4 meter, if the radius of curvature is 4 meter, then the focus is lies at 2 meter and between 2 meter, between this center of curvature and the pole of mirror, between the focus is lies. Through the focus, the ray of the light passes. Through the focus, the ray of light will be passes. I will tell you about the more information in my next video. So now try to understand what is that focus. Focus means a point which is lies on the principle of axis between the center of curvature and the pole of mirror. Center of curvature and the pole of mirror, both between it lies the focus. Yes? But the focus, the point lies on the principle of axis between the center of curvature and the pole of mirror. It is denoted by capital F. It is always denoted by capital F. This is the focus. Where we have to draw focus? At the middle of the center of curvature and the pole of mirror. No need to look the principle of axis at the time. But we have to draw the point where? On the principle of axis. We have to draw the point on the principle of axis. But we cannot draw. Here you can say, I can write the focus length. No. You cannot write from the center of the outside on the principle of axis. We have to draw the where, the pole of mirror, we have to indicate between the center of curvature and the pole of mirror. Okay? This is, suppose I told you this is the center, radius of curvature is 4 meter, then between the 2 meter and the 2 meter focus length is like focus. Now another is focal length. What is the focal length? Focal length is means the distance between the focus and the point, this pinpoint of what principle of what pole of mirror, that is the focal length. That is focal length, which is denoted by small f. It is denoted by small f, that is the focal length. What is that focal length? I will show you the focal length. Here you will see the focal length. Focal length. This focal length means what? The focal length means radius of curvature. R is equal to 2f. Here 1f and this is also the f. Yes, f and f, 2f. So radius means what? F plus f. Here f plus f. Radius of curvature means what? F plus f. It means R is equal to 2f. What is 2f? Or we can write f is equal to r by 2. It means focal length is equal to what? Radius by curvature by 2. What is our formula also we can write? Focal length is for what? Radius of curvature by 2. Once again I will show you the distance between the focus to the principle of axis, that is the focal length, and the distance between the center of curvature and the focus is also the focal length. So don't be confused here. This is the actual length between the center of curvature and the focus, focal length, and the distance between the focus and the pole of mirror, that is also the focal length, which is denoted by small f. Now I have shown you here radius of curvature, that is denoted by r, is equal to focus plus focus, focal length plus focal length, the f 2f, and f is equal to r by 2. It means what is our required formula? Focal length to calculate the focal length is r by 2. I hope that you understand and you have noted in all these videos. Thank you, class.